I'm Sarah Hardesty, and I'm participating in the Arlington Arts Studio Tour, and this is a little glimpse into my studio. Thanks for joining me here, and I'm going to talk a little bit about my process and some of the things I've been working on, and show you some detailed images of some of the works in progress, and I have a few completed works in here as well. My studio is at the Arlington Arts Center, and there are a number of studios upstairs here, and it's a great community. I love having a studio here, and whenever I can, coming to work. It's been a little different lately, so I haven't been in here as much, but when I do come in, it's a sanctuary, and I'm always very grateful to have this space to work in. So let's have a look, see what's going on in here. So I'm just gonna kind of walk through the space and show you what my working space looks like here. I kind of have a few works up that are complete that I want to keep around. And this is my working wall over here. Some of my old installations over there. Working on a lot of drawings and paintings right now in the studio. Oil stick and graphite and acrylic. All works on panel and paper. I do a lot of drawing and painting and installation. And lately, I've just been focusing more on the drawing and painting aspect. I usually work on both kind of at the same time, but installations happen a little bit less. A lot of what I'm doing in the studio over the past year or so, I would say, is working with a lot of layers and adding to and carving into the surface. Sometimes I'm working on older pieces that have been complete and kind of covering them and trying to show some of the past. This piece here is an example of an older painting underneath a newer painting. This piece is complete, by the way. I have it out, and here and there I will bring out other works to have around in the studio to kind of learn from or remind me of something, or they're going into a show or something like that. So in the background, there's acrylic, micaceous iron oxide paint, and a bunch of gouache mark making that I've done with a brush and kind of a liquid gouache. And it's in the silhouette shape of a flying bird. This is a pelican. I don't know if you can see it. My work is fairly abstract, but here and there I do pull on specific source imagery. So this one's a flying pelican, and each of the gouache marks make up the silhouette of the pelican. On the surface, I've responded to the bird form with pretty simple brush strokes on the top of white, and then on the bottom, I think it was a combination of copper, color, paint, and maybe a little bit of micaceous iron oxide. But dealing with the above and the below of the bird, and this idea of visible support, weightlessness, and also kind of patching over and mending maybe the past and creating a new form that's specifically based on the past and what was, but it is still there. We can still kind of see it, even though it's not quite as clear. So I think a lot about time and experiences, overlapping, excavating. This one is also an older piece that I painted over, and it was very much process-based. I wasn't exactly sure how much I was going to cover as I was making the marks. The surface marks are oil stick, and underneath is acrylic and gouache and pen and ink. So you can see some of the surface there with the ink, and then the intensity and rawness of the oil stick going over. But as I'm working, I just kind of respond to what seems like the right thing to do. And then if I'm not quite sure, I take a breath, I take a pause, I wait and see if I want to cover it up. And I think there's a fair amount of risk taking for me in the process of the work. For the drawings and paintings, the risk is that I'm not quite sure what's going to happen on the surface. But it does remind me about just going for it and making some kind of action and then responding to that action. This one's very much in process, but I wanted to show you Sometimes I use the back of a paintbrush and draw lines into the paint when it's still wet. It's a lot easier to do with oil. I've also done it with acrylic. There's some other work over there. But yeah, I keep my parts of the installations around. One of the things that I hope to do more of soon is work with aluminum. This piece very much directly responds to geological shifts in formation. I've been working on that a lot with my work. These are some of the old materials from installations. This is a mirror mosaic on found discarded wood, and I kind of arranged it in the corner called Silver Linings. And this is painted found wood that has been in a couple of different places in my art. It's shown up. But I like keeping these things around. You know, my work is pretty monochromatic right now, and keeping some of that color and vibrancy in my studio is really nice for me, and kind of keeps me connected to that. So thanks for coming through my studio virtually and sharing some of what I'm working on in the studio and some of my process. I hope you enjoy the rest of the studio tour. You can keep up to date with what I'm working on my website. It's sarahhardesty.com. I usually try to put in the news section what's going on. I try to add new work when I can. And you can also follow me on Instagram if that's something you do. And my Instagram page is Hardesty Art. So thanks again for joining me. Okay, bye. Stay safe.